sorry, you make it.
We're just reviving everyone. I don't know why it does it, but this game randomly selects game types I never selected for quick play. Like, yeah, I had a kill confirmed and hardpoint selected. That first game was Prisoner Rescue for no reason. Like, I never selected it. I never intended to play it. I never wanted to play it. Whatever. Anyway, what's up, guys? It's Morris, and welcome back to Modern Warfare 2. You know how, like, Modern Warfare 2019 and Vanguard, you can make some goofy-looking classes, even Cold War a little bit. Then we have certain guns that you can make resemble other guns from other games. Well, I've made a few of those, and I'm gonna split this up into a couple different videos, just because I feel like putting them all in one is just... You know, I want to milk it. I want to drag it out as long as possible. So today we're using the DSR 50 from Black Ops 2. And yes, most of these classes are actual reaches. And yes, most of these classes are complete reaches, but there has to be content somewhere. So anyway, if you happen to enjoy, then leave a like, subscribe to the channel, all that stuff. Leave a comment, whatever is on your mind, whatever's in that little pea brain of yours. I don't know why I'm insulting you. I don't know you. I don't know who you are. Anyway, this is a DSR. The DSR 50 from Black Ops 2, the game that made me who I am. Nice. Anyway, the reason I chose this scope is because it has the three little knobs like the DSR scope. Does it look like the DSR? Oh yeah, the MCPR 300 is basically the most DSR-esque sniper in the game, so that's why I'm considering it that. And this is a class setup I have where I essentially just tuned everything to make it really fast. Oh shit, SM2 just put out another weapon showcase. Oh my god, that's dope. Okay. If you don't know what SM2 is, by the way, it's basically just all the Call of Duties in one. It's a project that's been being built by just random people for, not random people, but not Call of Duty developers. It's being built by, like, third-party developers for, like, what is it, years at this point. Come here! I don't have the best teeth in the world. I mean, they're not terrible, but I did need braces for a couple years and I've chipped two of my teeth? I don't know, my teeth are a mess. It's a disaster out here. I'm struggling so hard. By the time I'm 75, I'm gonna look like a 15-year-old dog who is just like, they just have nubs of teeth left. You know, every single old dog you've ever met, how many of them have perfect teeth? Let's be honest. I mean, I wish they did. My sister, she has dogs, and she absolutely takes care of them better than anyone else I know at all. She literally treats them like little royalty, like mini royalty. But even them, by the time they're 15, 16, their teeth are probably going to be rotting. And that's exactly how my teeth are going to be. I don't know if it's just that I didn't drink enough milk growing up, or maybe I didn't... I did brush my teeth enough, because I never had cavities growing up. My teeth are just weak. They're like, you know... Not good. My teeth are about as strong as my emotional fortitude. My teeth are weaker than my will to live. My teeth are relatively weak and they also kind of stained. It's not that I don't brush my teeth. I brush my teeth at least once or twice a day. I do every morning and night. Sometimes I'll miss a night just because I'm like, I'm just going to bed. But for the most part, I brush them at least twice a day. And I brush solid. I learned when I had braces, I learned how to brush my teeth. Like, you don't understand the struggle unless you've had braces yourself. If you haven't had braces, you don't know the struggle. It is a pain trying to keep your teeth clean because you're literally brushing around like metal fences in your mouth. It's horrible. But I've learned that to actually make sure you don't just brush the bottoms of your teeth, you brush the whole tooth. You have to kind of feel like you're brushing your gums, and you should brush your gums and all that stuff too. And, you know, circular motion and that. Guys, okay. Never mind. But yeah, anyway, over time from like, I don't know if it's from eating sugary foods or drinking coffee or tea or whatever, my teeth have just stained. And I'm not really sure what all you can do about that besides, you know, eat healthier and like whiten your teeth or whatever. I'm personally not that big on spending money on just like appearance things. Like I'm not gonna buy the most expensive clothes or anything just cause I just don't care that much. If my teeth are a little bit stained, whatever. I don't like it, but I'm not gonna spend a bunch of money to whiten them. It's stupid, pointless. Also, with some of the older whitening stuff, it's just apparently, so I've heard the like older whitening strips and stuff are hard on your teeth. I never really bothered. I'd rather have slightly yellow teeth than broken teeth, which I mean, I do have broken teeth anyway, so maybe it doesn't matter at this point. But yeah, I can come up with like a million different reasons as to why I haven't whitened my teeth. The most important one is that I'm just lazy. I don't care enough to. But today, that has changed. I was talking to my mom the other day about whitening my teeth and asking if she had any like whitening strips that I could use, because I'm not gonna spend money on whitening strips. Quad feed! Nice. And she actually told me something I wasn't expecting at all. She switched up on me. She changed. She gave me a new nugget of information that I can use to my advantage. She told me that she actually uses hydrogen peroxide now. She doesn't use whitening strips anymore. And to me, like, I don't know. That's just weird to me. Why would you use hydrogen peroxide? It's like rubbing alcohol, isn't it? Isn't it the same stuff? Like, if you drink that, don't you die? So why are you actively putting it in your mouth? Why are you willingly putting that in your mouth? Like, wouldn't that shit kill you, if not make you incredibly sick? Apparently not, because I Googled it. Apparently it's widespread common sense that you can just mix hydrogen peroxide with some water and just swish it around your mouth for like 30 seconds a day, a minute a day or whatever. And over a couple weeks, your teeth just get super white. And apparently it doesn't damage your teeth or any of that stuff. It's just strictly only good for you, as long as you don't swallow it. So I figured I would just give it a try. Why not? I mean, the worst that can happen is I die, and then I don't have to worry about my teeth being white anyway. So I tried it today. I mixed a little bit of water with a little bit of hydrogen peroxide, 3% hypo. I'm gonna call it hypo. I'm not gonna call it hypo. So I did that, swish around in my mouth for a while, and it foamed up and got weird, like just a weird feeling. It's not really bad. You can't taste it. I don't know how or why, but you could put that in someone's drink and they would have no idea. You would just poison them slowly. I wonder what happens if you cook with hydrogen peroxide. I'm not gonna ask. Oh, hydrogen peroxide is just water with an extra oxygen molecule. Apparently, in its pure form, it's a very pale blue liquid that is slightly more viscous than water. DSR time, baby. Yeah, I don't know why. I just always assumed that it was poisonous to drink. I guess, like, is it even poisonous? Can you just drink hydrogen peroxide? It's just water with more air. Right? Not air. Oxygen is not air. But, like, we breathe oxygen. We need that shit. So, like, can... I don't know. I don't understand. Chemistry is interesting. The way you combine chemicals together decides whether it kills you or it helps you live longer. But anyway, I'm not recommending that you try swishing hydrogen peroxide in your mouth for long periods of time at all. I'll do it and report back and let you know if I think it's safe or not. You bitch. I know you're not supposed to, but honestly, how is this even allowed on camera? How is this allowed on YouTube? This is just way too sexual of an act. Yeah, honestly, this thing doesn't really look like the DSR at all. I mean, like, I tried doing the scope that had the three knobs on it, but then one knob's on the wrong side, and then it has the scope covers, which, I mean, this would look great on the links on the Signal 50. It would make it look more like the Barrett with the scope covers and stuff. I miss, dude, the MW2 Smiley scope cover. That shit, where, like, the tongue sticking out on the Y2K. Oh my, or I think it was also on the Barrett. But like, that shit is so memorable. Why don't they put the stuff like that in Call of Duty anymore? Or video games in general. Just nice, funny shit. I tried doing the barrel that looked most like the DSR and the scope that looked most like the DSR. And then like even the muzzle brake, I tried doing that real fat muzzle brake that's on the DSR. It's so so animated, so cartoonishly big. Imagine if someone said that about like your fucking dick or something. She's like, oh my God, it's so cartoonishly big.
Oh, I hate myself.
I need Jesus so bad. But yeah, I tried making this thing look the most DSR-ish I could, and it just obviously didn't work. I also gotta schedule a doctor's appointment tomorrow. I gotta do adult responsibility things. Today I fixed a leak in the basement. Tomorrow I'm scheduling a doctor's appointment. 2 days from now, I'll be buying overalls. I'm growing up. But yeah, I gotta schedule a doctor's appointment because my nose is, I have to have a sinus infection or something. The lack of breathing is startling. Stuff caught up in my face is just, ugh, it's nasty. And also, it's making it tough to talk sometimes. Anyway, yeah, that was the complete reach of a DSR 50 in Modern Warfare 2. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, leave a like. If you did not, leave an angry comment. Please complain. Hope you have a good day. It's been Morse. I'll see you next time.